Hello, hello, Jason Baker here with Rise Real Estate, and I got my fishing shirt on. I was just about to take my kids out fishing to the pond, and I said, you know what? This market is changing very quickly, and I need to get out one of the most important market updates I've done over the last, 5, 6, 7, 8 years. We are moving into a normalizing market, and I want to go over what that means for everybody. Okay, I've been saying for the last 4 or 5 months, because I can feel it in our own listing inventory, and just knowing what's going on in the world, financially with the markets, with inflation, everything else, that a change was coming, that there was going to be some financial ramifications going on. And so I just want to talk about those things right now, so that you, if you're planning on doing anything this year, whether buying or selling, can make educated decisions, right? So important. So our inventory about mid-July basically overnight doubled. And it went from both counties, Ravalli and Missoula County, okay, where we do 90% of our business. Now we do some in Mineral. We love Mineral County. We love Lake County as well. We've even gone out as far as Great Falls and Butte. But in the two counties where we do most of our business, the inventory was hovering around 80 residential homes for sale, okay, up until July 10th to 15th, somewhere in there, okay? Now, currently, right now, we have 180 homes for sale and residential homes for sale in Missoula County. And in Ravalli County, we have 163. Days on market are creeping up a little bit because, again, we have 2 to 2.5 times, the inventory, 2.25 times the inventory on the market than we did a month or 45 days ago. So we need to talk about what the importance of increasing inventory in our market, because it's really the baseline or the bellwether. It's how we determine, how much money a seller is going to net when they go to sell their home, and also when buyers are looking at homes, what they can expect to find out there in the market. So there's 4 major reasons that the inventory increased so rapidly. Number one, the government ended this forbearance, or the lenders have ended this forbearance period. So if you're affected by COVID, effectively you could not make a payment for a while, and they could not, in theory, they're supposed to take all those 15, 16, 17, 18 past due payments and put them onto the end of your loan. But that's not happening, I'm hearing that they just owe all of that money, because it's like an act of Congress to get your bank to do that. It just doesn't automatically happen. So then on August 1st, really, that was a Sunday, so August 2nd, the banks could now issue, because of those late payments for many people that were not able to work something out, and there was numbers where people were telling me 1 in 10, 1 in 11 Montana homeowners is in some sort of forbearance program, which that's a huge amount of homes if you think about that. So the foreclosures are, the banks could start foreclosing again. That moratorium on foreclosures ended on the 1st, really the 2nd, like I said. So now they're given a notice of default. Now those people who are given a notice of default get a notice in the mail or something, nailed on their door or taped on their door or whatever. It says, certified mail, says you have 120 days to cure, or your house is now our house. We're going to go through with the foreclosure. 120 days they have to sell that home and wrap up their affairs or make up all the past due payments, okay? It's very difficult. If you can't make one payment, it's very difficult to make 15, 16, 17 payments, right? Would you agree with that? The third reason is the rental market. So the rental properties are now, their landlords, the moratorium, so in other words, people that have to make rent this whole entire time. Imagine, it's terrible that they're out of work or whatever else, but every person around here is hiring. We can't get anybody to come out here and do any work on our house, on our farm down here in Florence. And so, but there's a lot of jobs out there that are available. But anyways, a lot of people were affected income-wise, and they were harmed because, again, they were out of work. And so there was a moratorium on being able to kick people out of their rentals. Well, those landlords are suffering that own the home too. They're no longer getting those rent. They're having to make their mortgage payments. So it's just a vicious cycle. But anyway, that protection was ruled unconstitutional. The CDC cannot mandate that. I don't like either situation. I don't like when a renter is being thrown out in the road, and I don't like it when a landlord's not getting his money, because obviously they have bills too, and they could be thrown out in the road. But anyway, the whole thing just stinks, right? So the rentals, so those people are, we've listed a bunch of rentals lately. So we've listed people that are in forbearance, people that are almost going to go in foreclosure, and also rentals. Now, the biggest segment of people coming to the market, now that the inventory of 80 units for sale is like nothing. That's like, that's across all price ranges, the whole entire county, right? That's nothing. So there were so many people. We had our best listing month of the year in August of all times. And most everybody goes on vacation. Like, you didn't do any real estate in August hardly. We had one of our best months for closings and also for listings taken in the month of August. August. Why? Because the people, we had a long list of people who were so scared they weren't going to be able to find their next home because there was only 80 homes in the market in the whole county, probably 20 in their town or 10 in their town or 5 in their town. So those holdouts, those people who were not listing because they were afraid they couldn't find, they're coming to the market now. That's going to be the biggest, I believe, segment of people coming to the market. It's just the holdouts. Like, they're like, Jason, there's so many houses coming on the market now. Yeah, it is. So I really believe it's going to go up to 350 to 400. I don't know how long it's going to take. But when that happens, you have to remember, that's what it was 3 or 4 years ago. That was the average inventory being carried in both counties. So when that happens, it becomes a normal market. So, you know, days on market were 140 to 180 down in the Bitterroot. And, you know, down here, I live in the Bitterroot. And so, and it's one of, it's like, it's going to go back to what it was, you know. Very few people got so again when the inventory increases, here's some things that happen. Number one, less showings per home. Number two, less offers per home. I'm reading off a list. If you see me looking down, I don't have this all memorized. I just wrote this for you. Number three, we lose the multiple competing offers when there's a ton of homes on the market. There's just other choices, right? So people aren't fighting over 80 anymore. Days on market increase. Price reductions increase. We've had 100 price reductions in the last 10 days. Think about that. When's the last time we've seen a price reduction? Go look at any of the major websites. You're gonna see price reductions everywhere. Now, so if the sellers who are given a notice of default, they pause, or they're like waiting till the last hour to do that. They're gonna basically have to sell their house for a little time to get less, and once that closes, then all the comps in the neighborhood could go down. More homes are going to start expiring because sellers are still way up here, but there's a lot of inventory. And so when homes expire, they typically come back on the market for less. So we're around a couple hundred homes for sale, or just under that in both counties. Remember, right now it's still a seller's market in every sense of the word, but we're teetering on that edge of a normal market, if that makes sense. And that normal market will eventually turn into a buyer's market or a quasi-buyer's market. I think this will happen over the next 6 to 9 months. I mean, the inflation is going to raise interest rates. It always does. There's got to be some sort of, I mean, if you look at the world right now, it's just kind of all, this isn't a political statement, but it's just kind of all over the place. And that's never good for confidence in the financial market. Well, the stock market's good. Well, is it falsely inflated? Well, I think there's a lot of people that would probably say yes. So we want to hedge our bets. We want to do a stop loss on what we potentially could make less on our houses if we're going to go to sell them. We're going through the process right now with a property we have in Missoula. So the solution is, if you're on the fence, we should probably have a discussion, okay? We should, unless your house is listed with someone else, of course, delete this message. But we should have a discussion. We can talk on the phone. You can talk to one of my assistants if you don't feel like talking with me, if you think, you know, you don't like my unibrow or something like that, or I'm too upfront or whatever. That's fine. You know, we could do a Zoom, or I could come over and visit. Especially if you're like cooking barbecue, you know, that night. So, but anyway, I just wanted to. And then for buyers, guys, I think you're gonna see some really. I don't think you're gonna see like these super amazing deals lately, but you're gonna be able, if you go look at a house and put an offer in, I think over the coming months, you're really gonna have a much better chance of not having to compete against 5, 10, 15, 20 other offers. I think, you know, the offers per house are gonna go down to 1 or 2. But anyway, there is your market update. Hopefully something in there was educational. If not, you know, the great news is you can always delete these emails or just hit stop on the YouTube or wherever you happen to be watching it. So have a great day. Jason Baker, Rise Real Estate. And please remember the families all the families, either from the deceased or the injured over in Afghanistan. My family is praying for them, and hopefully yours is too, or sending good thoughts their way, okay? And we'll talk to you later. Thanks.